Hello everyone, welcome back with another interesting video lecture on thelaziasis or eyeworm infection in different animals such as cattle, buffalo, horse, dog and cat. In this lecture, I'm gonna discuss the important species of eyeworms of different animals, their morphological features and life cycle. Later on, I will discuss the pathogenesis, clinical signs, diagnosis and treatment of thelaziosis or eyeworm infection in different animals. If you like this video, put your comments or feedback in the comment section below. Your feedback will be highly appreciated. If you want to get more video lecture on the parasitic diseases of animals, don't forget to subscribe the channel. The major species that cause thelaziasis or eyeworm infection in various animals are listed here. Thelazia rhodesi, Thelazia gullosa, Thelazia scargiavini are commonly found in cattle and buffalo. Thelazia rhodesi can also be found in sheep and goat. Thelazia lacrimalis is mostly found in horse, but also be found in buffalo, camel, and dog. There is another parasite, another eyeworm of camel, which is Thelazia leishi. Thelazia californiensis, also known as California eyeworm, can be found in sheep, deer, cat, and dog. This parasite is also recorded in man. Thelazia calipeda is the parasite of dog, but can also be found in rabbit and man. The location of all these parasites is in the eye, especially in the conjunctival sac or lacrimal duct. Thelazia scargiavini can also be found in vitreous humor of eye of buffalo. Thelazia calipeda is also observed under the nictitating membrane of the eye of dog. The intermediate host for this parasite are different species of mussel fly or house flies. Among these parasites, Thelazia calipeda, also known as oriental eyeworm, Thelazia californiensis have genotic significance. Thelazia gullosa has very little genotic significance. It is also noted that the eyeworm of poultry is Oxyspirura mansoni, and for human it is Loa loa. Morphological features of Thelazia species. Grossly, the parasite is small, thin, milky white in color. Size is around 1 to 2 centimeter. Microscopic features include cup-shaped buccal capsule, and cuticle has prominent transverse striation. You can see here, and you can see in this picture and in this picture. And this cuticular striation is very important for initiating inflammation in eyes. So that we will discuss in the pathogenesis section. Life cycle of Thelazia species. Life cycle is indirect as there is involvement of intermediate host. Final host of this parasite are listed in previous slide. For an example, it could be cattle, buffalo, horse, dog, and different other animals. The predilection site for this parasite is the conjunctival sac and the lacrimal duct of eyes of different animals. Different species of mussel fly involve as intermediate host. Infective stage is L3. So you know the adult female parasite is viviparous. They will lay L1 in the lacrimal secretion while visiting the host. This L1 is further taken up by the fly during taking male on the final host. Development of L1 to L3 will be occurred in the flies within 15 to 13 days during summer month, or depending on the environmental factors. The flies then release L3 to the eyes or its surrounding area of vital host when they further visit the host for their feeding. Finally, adult parasites will be developed in eyes. For the completion of this life cycle, it will take around 3 to 11 weeks. It depends on different species as well as different environmental conditions. Pathogenesis of Thelaziasis or Eyeworm Infection. In the life cycle, we have seen that L3 will be developed in flies, and these infective stages will be released to the eyes of different final hosts while visiting those hosts for feeding. Lesions are caused by the serrated cuticle of the worms and their migration. As a result, conjunctivitis and keratitis will be developed. Due to these pathological conditions, excessive lacrimation will be there. This excessive lacrimation will further attract more flies, and these flies will further deposited L3 in the eyes. And due to the keratitis followed by ulceration of the cornea, if this corneal layer tears, the blindness will be resulted. Keratitis may also lead to corneal opacity. Clinical signs of thelaziasis or eyeworm infection. Major clinical signs include lacrimation, conjunctivitis, photophobia, and painful eyes. Excessive lacrimation can also be understood by observing aggregation of large number of flies around the eyes. In severe cases, corneal opacity leading to blindness can be seen. An observation of the gross parasites in the eyes has diagnostic value. Diagnosis and treatment of thelaziasis or eyeworm infection. For the occurrence of this parasitic infection, season is considered as an important factor. Usually more fly activity is seen in summer as well as rainy season. So the transmission of this parasitic infection would be more in the season. Further, asymptomatic carrier animals also act as the source of infection for different other healthy animals. There is no specific clinical sign for the diagnosis of the eyeworm infection or thelaziasis. Observation of worms in the conjunctival sac confirms the eyeworm infection. It is also noted that instillation of a few drops of local anesthetic may be necessary for the manipulation of the third eyelids. Laboratory confirmation include the examination of lacrimal secretion under the microscope, which will reveal eggs or larvae of the eyeworm. Treatment of thelaziasis or eyeworm include the manual removal of worms and later administration of different types of anthelmintics such as levamisole or ivermectin, which is very effective in this case. And topical application of 1% aqueous solution of ivermectin can also be done. And finally, the prevention of this parasitic infection. Prevention of this thelaziasis or eyeworm infection is very difficult because of ubiquitous nature of the fly vectors. These are the references that I have used to prepare this presentation. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel to get more video lecture on parasite of animals. Thank you for watching this video and good luck for your study.